Okay, in this video, I'm going to be discussing, is Pal World actually better than Pokemon Scarlet and Violet? I already have my answer, but I'll let you decide based on after hearing my experience. So, first things first, I would like to say that I do enjoy this whole like raid thing where you can have your base and someone tries to raid it, be it a human or a pal or a group of pals, whatever the case. I think that's awesome because you got tower defense inside of a game that's already a survival game. So I picked the high ground, which I'm glad I did. I just chose it on accident because I was trying to find something close, but it helped a lot because these guys are having a hard time coming up to fight my base. So I just killed them pretty easily with the crossbow. Yes, I got a crossbow because that thing hits hard. As you can see, I made quick work of them, took out the ops. And then I got to take all of their stuff, all of their gold, 736 gold. That's crazy, right? I'm not gonna lie and say it's a perfect game. It's still in early access, so there are some bugs. I will also say though, there's a lot of things you can unlock. You can unlock all these different types of things to create, to add to your base, to help you. You can find treasure chests around, like as you explore this giant open world, you can find treasure chests. You can set up your pals to burn things for you, like this thing called an ingot. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing it right, but my Firefox pal, he can burn it for me and produce it. And those things are really important in the game to create items. I also get to hang glide. So imagine hang gliding to come down and swoop down and attack. I get to mine for ore. I get to use my pickaxe and mine for ore. So many things you get to do in this game. Your pals can also mine for ore for you. I think it's also pretty cool how I get to ride my pals. They attack as soon as you send them out, some of them, I think depending on their personality, which I think is also pretty dope. That other pal was just minding its own business, and as soon as I threw out my little pig pal, he was like, "Square up, bro." Whenever you get hungry in a survival game, I'm just eating berries for right now because that's all I really need. And berries are right by my base. I also have a ton of pals that I've caught already. That's how I reached this level. And how I've been getting them, I've just been using my crossbow, going behind them, and then hitting them with a spear. Just throwing that ball at them and catching them. Because I noticed that if you get right behind them and you shoot them with a powerful weapon, it does almost all their health. So it makes it pretty easy to get them. This Eevee looking thing, which it's kind of hard not to have something looking like Eevee if you have a round head and it's a fox animal, but that's besides the point. People are going to argue that all day. It doesn't really matter to me. If Nintendo wants to sue them, they can. That's the bottom line. What people don't understand is Nintendo has never stopped themselves from suing somebody. Okay, and here's another one I found. Look, notice how I go right behind them and then I hit him with a spear again. This little shadow bird thing. Can't remember what it's called. Hoot crate or something like that. Hoot crate. Yeah, got one. Here's this other one. Yes, I stabbed it while it's sleeping like a psychopath. Another hoot crate right behind. Throw that spear. Got him again. Not gonna lie, it's kind of enjoyable. Now, here is where I did something really stupid. I wanted to see how strong this fire boar was against this giant mammoth. Even though it was level 38 and I was nowhere close to level 38, I was like, let me try my luck. Let me try to do a pro gamer move. This was not a pro gamer move. This was a stupid move. And as you can see, I have no chance. I just did that fire attack and it barely grazed him. It was like a mosquito bite, basically. So I'm sitting there watching this giant elephant trying to survive, and I'm like, okay, I'm outgunned. I can't really do anything to him. And I tried to throw my pals to see if they can just do some stuff, but they're not able to do anything. I thought getting this like machine gun thing on the squirrel was gonna help me, but that barely did any damage too. I definitely think your level plays a huge factor in the damage, like a huge factor. Yeah, I'm trying to run away from him, but that didn't work. I ended up dead. In the game, you can make nests for your pals, like a place for them to sleep, and you can set them up however you want. People would probably think this was like tacky or whatever, how I set it up, but I really don't care. It's not The Sims. It's a survival game slash monster tamer, so you can set it up however you want. So I got raided a second time during this video. And when I was recording, I did not expect how this was gonna play out. Because this time I got raided by pals. The two times before when I played this game, the two times before while playing this game, I did not get raided by pals. I got raided by human. It was like a human a terror group or whatever, I don't know what it's called. Outlaws. And so as I get raided by these pals, this one red beast goat thing runs up here super fast. I thought I was gonna have time to shoot him while he was down like the humans, but no. Both the pals, all of these pals, they scaled my little wall so easily, and I had to shoot them, and they're killing my pals, and I'm just having to shoot them and take them down. They have these like dark energy powers or whatever. I'm trying not to get hit, but I'm still getting hit because I'm running into stuff that I can't see at my base. He just took out like three of my pals so easily. Mind you, I had stronger pals, but I was not expecting a raid. I was just building stuff. Had I been paying more attention, I could have switched my team to where they could fight back better. Because I had some of my weakest pals defending my base at the time, which was really bad and unfortunate. That's why they got wiped out in a matter of seconds. But it adds to the challenge of the game, so I like that. I tried to move out the way, but I got blocked by my own mining field. And so here's why I have to like sit there and do the rest of the work mostly on my own. Well, the fox is helping me, but yeah, I end up doing some of the work on my own. I'm so glad I got the crossbow. If I did not get the crossbow, they would have killed me. They would have probably destroyed my entire base. The crossbow does way more damage than a lot of the other beginner weapons. Like significantly way more damage. You should get the crossbow as soon as possible. Yeah, I think one of the last things I ended up building for this video, I ended up building a mill because it was one of the tasks that you have to complete. Yeah, it was one of the tasks you have to complete in order to upgrade your base. So every once in a while they'll ask you to, well, not every once in a while, but like they'll ask you to build these different things to upgrade your base. Like once you have this and this, it's like a checklist. So you level up your base, you can add more pals to your base, and your base expands. I'm actually running out of room as we speak. I'm running out of room at my base because I don't think I picked a good enough location, like enough open space, but I'm trying to use the space that I do have to build my base. I should also mention that I did do a boss battle against that giant Grizzbolt or whatever it's called. That was fun, and I want to get a Grizzbolt once I get a chance. There is so much more challenge and thought in this game than in some other games. This game has successfully managed to put in so many different features from so many different game genres into one game, and I think that's a great thing that it's done. If you enjoyed watching this video, be sure to subscribe and like and share. Find out what happens next time on the OFC.